death sauce, chipotle.
Uh-oh, going.
All right. That's some hot shit right there, boy.
It's pretty warm. But it's not intolerable, though. Like, it's not that bad.
It gets worse.
Yeah, if you breathe. Like, when you breathe, yeah. It sucks.
Ah, when you life, it sucks. What are you talking about? That's rough, bro. I feel like I'm sweating right now.
I think I'm okay.
It's like in the back of my throat.
Oh my god. It's still so hot.
It's like getting worse. Going to the bathroom later is gonna suck.
You got any milk?
Nah. You need some milk.
Yeah. I'm sick as hell, man.
Oh, you got boogers too. Dang. Them Jones is amazing, yo. Look at them Jones. Oh, no.
Anyway. As a tattoo artist, I usually get hit with the same questions over and over again. It's not wrong with it, but I figure I might as well answer the main one.
Oh my god, you do tattoos though? Oh my god, like how did you get started in tattooing?
So, here's what happened.
So basically, I just wanted like a quick way to get some money so I can buy some weed, so I can smoke a lot with my friends and do hood rat shit. So I ended up going on Amazon, I got like a $25 kit, and I started tattooing people all over the place. Like, man, no stencils, no gloves, no nothing. I just wanted to get some money, so that's what I did.
Man, I'm lying like shit, boy. I ain't do all that. Ain't nobody got time for that. But for real, though, here's what really happened. First of all, I've been drawing my whole life, yo. I can't remember when I wasn't drawing, yo. You gotta know how to draw, yo. I still remember going up to see my grandma. She used to put on Bob Ross. I used to get so pissed off, yo, because it would take me 3 hours to draw this mountainscape. And he would do it in like one stroke.
You can bring it right in front. You can move mountains. You can do anything on this canvas.
Really, nigga? Midway through high school, I started drawing up shit, you know, for my homeboys. They used to always come up and be like, hey, draw me up a tat, cuz. But I wasn't really fully into it at that time, because I don't really care about much else but hanging, yo. I just wanted to chill with the homies. I just want a regular-ass job with a regular-ass pay. Then my dumbass turned 18, and lo and behold, dumbass got in trouble. It wasn't nothing serious, man. It didn't even stick. But still, I just, at that point, I was just ready to stop bullshitting and just try to figure out what the hell I wanted to do in life, and tattooing was it, man. So I stayed up almost every night, drew a bunch of pictures, made a portfolio, went around to every shop in the area, though, every last one, asked for apprenticeship, because I knew that was the right way to do it. Every one of them told me no, straight up, yo. But that ain't stopped anything, though. And I was in class with this one dude, man. I saw his artwork and I asked him where he got it. He told me where he went, so I liked his work, so I was like, man, I'm gonna check it out. It was that Ink House Tattoo over in Route 6 in La Plata. Quentin Spradley was his name. Basically, the number one thing I've learned, you bring someone money, they cannot deny you. So he told me no, just like everybody else. But I started bringing him money, y'all. I would draw stuff for people and be like, look, I will only draw this if you go see him. And finally, I guess after being annoying as hell, he finally sat me down and was like, yo, you've been bringing me money. Obviously, you got some kind of clientele. I can give you a job. I can teach you how to tattoo, but I can't pay you, bro. So of course, I'm just like, shit, I can start today. What's up? Yeah, man, I worked for that man for free for a year, yo. Scrubbing tubes and sweeping floors and scrubbing toilet and doing bitch work for a year for free, bro. But in turn, he taught me how to tattoo, man. All the basics, everything I needed to know. Long story short, things fell off. I ended up leaving the shop. So I started tattooing in my mama house in the basement. G shit. Thank you, mama. Love ya. Or I'll go to your house, man. Wherever, bro. Look, I'll admit it, man. I was a scratcher. You give me anywhere you want me to tattoo at, I was going to do it, man. Like, I was a straight scratcher, bro. I'll just admit it, man. That's how it went. Then my boy Dana, yo.
Why you all up on me, man?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
Nah, I don't.
He trapped me down for 2 years. Kept on saying, hey, yo, man, come in here, get this money. Blase, 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 blase. And my dumb ass, so hardhead, I kept on saying no. I don't know why. Stupid, I guess, man. Just kept on saying no. But finally, he convinced me, bro. I started working for him, and that was it, man. Once I got in there, I was hooked. I quit my other job and did all, you know, I did what I had to. And here I am now, man, still doing it. But that's how I started, man. That's how I got down, and, you know, the rest is history, bro. Thanks for listening.
Yeah. Yeah. Growing up, they told me follow your dreams. Now I got these A-list chicks all in my jeans. 5'8 and she only weighs 120. Skinny, but she's got an ass. The conundrum is funny. And you don't have to like me, just the boss to tell me. When your girl needs D, then she calls a celly. Now they see me coming up, swing, they all get jelly. Karate kid, yeah, my sensei is Fonzarelli. That's 40. I come from the land of the hyphy. My club is all pros, like the brand of a white tee. Only $1 million in my hand will excite me. And I'm touring across the Atlas, and I plan to go sightsee. I never talk back when you're trying to diss us. Cause my response when we know you're lying is crickets. If I ain't popping, please explain who's buying the tickets. And my deal's not a deal, it's like they're buying a business, yeah.
You could be anything in this world. You could be anything in this world. Mama said you could be anything in this world. You could be anything in this world. But of all things in this life you could pick to be, you sure look like a hater or a bitch to me. Of all things you could pick to be, you sure look like a bitch to me.
They call me short, but I started at the top. NorCal bitch, if you like it or not. It is what it is, it's an Oakland thing. What you doing short? I'm just smoking, man. I got her thinking I'm the man to be. Fuck with me, this ain't no fantasy. We them real bay boys, all we do is make noise. We ain't never been quiet, come through and take hoes. I hope you don't get mad cause she want me. I really don't want her, I just wanna get money. If you see me cupcake, give a fuck what you think. She's a rich girl, and I'm in love with her bae. You wanna be like her, want a car like that, wanna be my work. I be your mentor, baby, I make you a motherfucker. You take all this money and that other sucker, bitch.
You could be anything in this world, you could be anything in this world. Mama said you could be anything in this world, you could be anything in this world. But of all things in this life you could pick to be, you sure look like a hater or a bitch to me. Of all things you could pick to be, you sure look like a bitch to me. I leave the club with a bad one, head right to my spot. Put some Ty Dolla on and put a pipe in a thot. Got a style the world likes it a lot. I get on track, spit, sneeze, cough, and throw up. I'm not wiping the snot. On my way, if you like it or not. I'm looking at the top, I'm just eyeing the spot. And I just keep climbing, I've been hiking a lot. If you told me these things would all happen, you'd be right on the spot, yeah. Cause ever since I was able to grow fame, my superpowers, I can swoop your girl with no game. Straight to the point with no shame. Spot her at the party, I'm alone. This is a sniper with pro aim. If you're a bitch, then respect you won't gain. Most of these cats are so lame. Rapper fell off, turned into a no name. Lost it all, now you're trying to grow your buzz back like Rogaine. It won't.
You could be anything in this world. You could be anything in this world. Mama said you could be anything in this world. You could be anything in this world.
But of all things in this life you could pick to be, you sure look like a hater or a bitch to me. Of all things you could pick to be, you sure look like a bitch to me. Yeah.
Oh, my titties are sweating.
See how it looked? Oh, you know, it looked horrible with the light there.
Oh, man.